Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Wang. Here is the question. If x, y, and z are real numbers, we want to solve this equation for x, y, and z values. We only have one equation. This equation contains three variables, x, y, and z. And it is nonlinear. Looks very difficult to solve this equation for x, y, z values. How to solve it? We are going to introduce a special method to dealing with this kind of question. From this given condition, we have this equation. Then we move everything from the right-hand side to the left-hand side. We are trying to group different variables. For example, put all x terms together, y terms together, and z terms together. What are we doing this? We want to make complete squares for each terms, x terms, y terms, z terms. Is this equation true? Yes. What are extra? So here we have extra one here. Here we have negative one and a positive one. Both are canceled out. Here we have negative 2 and a positive 2. We have negative 1. Negative 1, positive 1 are canceled each other. Therefore, this equation is true. What is the first part? First part is the square root of x minus 1, then square. Because x equals square root of x, then square. Similarly here, y minus 1 equals square root of y minus 1, then square. Therefore, this second group is square root of y minus 1, then square. Similarly, we have the result for the last group, which is square root of z minus 2, then minus 1, then square. Now we can compare the both sides of this equation. The right-hand side is 0. The left-hand side must be equal to 0 because the left-hand side is the sum of all three squares. Each square is bigger than or equal to 0. Therefore, each square must be equal to 0 because the right-hand side is 0. Therefore, square root of x minus 1 equals 0. Square root of y minus 1, then minus 1 equals 0. Square root of z minus 2 minus 1 equals 0. Here should be equal to 0. Here should be equal to 0. Therefore, square root of x equals 1. Square root of y minus 1 equals 1. Square root of z minus 2 equals 1. Taking square on both sides for each result, then we have x equals 1, y minus 1 equals 1, z minus 2 equals 1. Therefore, we have x equals 1, y equals 1 plus 1, which is 2, z equals 1 plus 2, which is 3. We have the final answer. X, y, z equals 1, 2, 3. That's all. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.